We're taking a pitch from Frank. He's got a big problem because his North Hollywood fourplex caught fire. We get a lot of investors reaching out from this area because it's up and coming with galleries, clubs, cafes. They're all drawing buyers and renters. The income potential is definitely there, and that's what brought us back.
Totally, yeah. So he has owned this building for like 20 plus years, had a fire in the back building. So the insurance company is going to give him 500 grand and he can rebuild.
Frank?
Yes.
How are you? How are
you? My gosh. Hello.
Nice to meet you.
Welcome to my nightmare.
Was the fire just the back unit or was it?
Fire was the back unit.
Oh, okay.
So how many units in the back, how many units in the front?
4 units and 2 units. A front house is where I live, a guest house, and a fourplex.
I thought the entire property was just 4 units. So
no.
You have 6 here.
Oh. I have 6, yeah.
Were there any injuries? Was there
No, there weren't any injuries. And originally, the fire started in the back.
Oh.
He was like smoking on the couch. And the couch went up in flames.
Yikes.
And then it burned up the side of the building. The fire department came, put it out, and then I looked up, I saw glowing.
Oh no.
And I said, I think there's fire in the attic. And giant flames. The whole attic was in flames.
Wow.
Burned the roof off. They came in with the engineers and everything from the insurance company, and it was just the roof and the back area. And here, I can show you back here.
Oh,
this,
yeah.
Yeah, this so is where the fire was.
And so it just wicked up the wall
it just
there.
And whipped up the wall, and the whole roof was engulfed in flames. My heart sank, absolutely sank.
Of the 4 units, how many were rented?
All of them.
What was your rent at? Were you at market value?
No. They were paying like $1,000 a month, basically. The downstairs studio unit was $1,100. The really large single, $975.
Oh, wow.
The thing is, a unit that size usually rents around $1,500. So you were completely undervaluing them.
When did the fire happen? How long ago?
A year, over a little over a year ago.
You had no income for over a year?
For over a year.
Okay.
I mean, I'm dipping into savings. It's bad. It's a bad situation. I have to pay the mortgage. I have no income. I literally have 3 months before I'm in big trouble. Honestly, at market value, 1 unit would pay the mortgage.
All right.
So, hey, it's been a minute since we've been over here.
I know, hey? We're in picturesque View Heights, which has both upscale homes and smaller, less pricey ones that really appeal to both buyers and renters.
Rental vacancy rates are just 1%.
We just came from Frank's. We're at Gil and Jessica's house. They have a very different project. Theirs is a garage that they want to convert to an ADU.
They've done a bunch of projects in the past, but it sounds like they've sort of just learned a little something and they just continue to do that.
Over the last 15 years, Jessica and I have purchased and sold about 10 properties.
Tell us a bit about the place. I mean, how long have you had this house?
We've had this since October the previous year. And our plan is essentially to turn this into an accessory dwelling unit. Our budget is $150,000. We have our plans that are going through. Maybe in the next 3 or 4 weeks, we'll get the permits.
So these guys, you can tell that they just want to learn. I have a little hesitation. I kind of get the feeling that they need less of our help when it comes to this actual specific project. And they're just more interested in taking a class from the Jonathan and Drew School of Real Estate, as opposed to us specifically getting them through this project. So this project here, it's $150,000 in. Potentially they'll be able to take that rental unit up to about $2,500, I think.
We already gave Jessica and Gil our advice, and I don't think they'll need us to finish their project successfully.
Okay. It's Frank. Okay. Let's give him a call.
Let's give him a ring.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hey.
Hello.
How you doing?
I'm very stressed.
We've got one crew coming available right away, and we did look at another project. We've weighed a lot of the pros and cons back and forth. We want to back you because we think it can really help you get this project done.
Thank you so much.
This will probably go over 500,000. We're going to do everything we can to keep it down.
Whatever I have to do, I'll make it happen. I'm so grateful. Thank you, guys. This is...
The first thing that has to happen with this place is we have to finish gutting it. Make everything safe, get everything prepared, and then start framing out for the new floor plan.
Yeah, from there, Frank can start making decisions about the layout and design for these new apartments.
Having Drew and Jonathan back me, it's making it a little easier, but it's way more than I ever thought it would be.
Oh, man. This is not good.
Of course, it hasn't even been a week, and I already have a text from Adam saying something is worse than we originally expected. Frank's stairs to the second floor apartments have termite damage. The pictures look nasty.
I don't feel safe standing under this. Yeah, these stairs are a nightmare. That's the thing, when you start to pull everything back, you find the surprises.
I wasn't planning on reframing the upper deck area, and obviously this needs some work.
What's the new cost for all this?
It's $6,000 to $7,000 to reframe it.
Ugh, this is the kind of thing you hate to see. You budget for what you think you have to replace, and then you see there's a lot more termite damage than we thought there was. It's missing structural integrity, so we have to rip out the stairs and build new. That's over $6,000.
How do you like the railings? Everything okay?
I love the railings, although it needs to be touched up.
Yeah.
You can see in a couple different places.
Yeah. We're doing like 360 paint touch-ups, stucco touch-ups, cleaning up the windows.
Okay. Because we're at crunch time and I'm nervous.
I know.
I get excited backing someone like Frank because he's a truly good person. He's got a big heart. He had this place sitting empty for over a year, and it was costing him a lot of money. He now has a huge opportunity.
We have high expectations, and now it's time to see if Frank has these places looking and feeling like they're in line with the nicest apartments in this neighborhood, or not.
I am excited. Oh, wow. Stop zhuzhing.
What do you think, yeah?
This is amazing. It's so nice. It looks incredible.
Better than I even imagined. I mean, just the outside alone is gorgeous.
It is. Let's get in
Come on in. Check it out. Wipe your feet.
Yes. Oh, my gosh. This
Isn't
is awesome.
This great?
Holy smokes.
Well, I'm going to let you guys tell me what you think.
This is so nice.
Oh, yeah.
This is...
Look at this.
The moment you walk in, it's a no-brainer. Someone will walk in and say, I have to take this. There's nothing else that compares.
Yep. This was the worst unit when the fire came. There was a huge hole in the roof from the fire.
Everything came together from the insurance, helping with the build.
It makes me cry. It really does. It makes me really emotional because, you know, I literally... That night of the fire, I didn't know what I was gonna do. And to stand here now and see everything, it's emotional for me. I'm so grateful for the opportunity. I'm so grateful that the brothers decided to back me. And thanks to you for giving me the helm of the ship and said, you're the captain, take this ship to port. And I did. We are in port now.
Thanks for not crashing the ship.
Yeah, the brothers turned a nightmare into a dream.
Frank had $500,000 in insurance money to cover this renovation. Our backing was valued at nearly $100,000, and all the work was completed in 12 weeks. While we donated materials, there were costs that weren't in our budget. Plus, Frank made interior choices that brought our budget up. But all in all, he came in right at the insured amount.
Originally, you were renting these units upstairs, the two one-bedrooms, for $1,000.
Right.
Now, you could get over $3,000 a month for these furnished.
Wow.
Now, downstairs, you can probably get around $3,600, $3,700 a month. Furnished?
Right.
But if you finish the backyard, you could get over $4,000.
Right.
You really could. So do you think you can pull together the $20,000 you would need for that backyard?
You know, I think it's a no-brainer for me to try and do that. I think I can do that.
You say a lot of, I think. I need something concrete.
Okay. So I think...
John and Adam have to get on other projects.
Right.
But we also have some great landscape teams that work with us in the next week. Let us know right away. That'll be the critical.
Yeah.
But if you can pull that money together, renting out these two units plus the downstairs, you'll actually be able to pull in about $120,000 a year.
Huge, huge difference.
You're set up for success.
Aw, thank you. Oh, I owe you a dinner. The house is done. It looks incredible. And trying to get the right rent, that's my biggest concern right now. This is my livelihood, and I only have one shot at it, and I want to make sure that I do it right.